a minute and tell you the order that it's going to go in. And all the judges are up here, right? All the judges here. She will lead you around to the kitchen, which is backstage. Guys, listen. Okay, she'll lead you around to the kitchen, which is backstage. You'll come here at the cross stage. Exit this way. Audience stage right. And then go out and come back in the back door.
It's rolling.
Okay, want me to go through that once more?
No!
Okay, just try to be as quiet as possible when you're going out and coming in so that the act on stage can get full attention. Ed's going to come out and explain the order. Okay, I'm going to introduce to you now the fabulous Warthog, Ed Heck.
Simply hi. I'm going to go over the instructions for the group because I know some of you are not that bright and I don't feel it's that bad to repeat them. Each group that is ready to perform will be preceded by the group which has to go back by the exit sign near the toilets, follow pad aisles, and she'll show you what to do. So we're going to hear from the steering committee. They're going to do something. Then the red team. There's no need to applaud for all this shit. Come on. The purple team. The yellow team. The blue team. The magnificent green team. The orange team, hey! Lori Birnbaum and Sherry Wheelberg. Hey! There's only two people, you're not going to get a big, you know. Sue, and then the fabulous Susan and David, followed by the supply shuffle. I'll try and provide guidance, but it should be obvious I'm mildly intoxicated. We have chosen impartial judges. I'd like to announce their names. Doug Pollum, a man who is very impartial. Mike Hannigan of the steering committee. Ron Michelle of the orange committee. Dave Brock of the red committee. Joe Ryan of the yellow. Susan Surface of the blue. And I think he's qualified for a variety of reasons which I won't go into. Now, before we get into our shtick, which will be the steering committee doing something, God knows what. Beg pardon? Who does the green team follow?
No, the green team judge. We were disqualified. Who's our replacement?
Don't worry about it. I can't answer all the questions. It's just like product management. You can't answer all the questions.
It's not your fault.
It's not my fault. Okay. Let's move right along. No interruptions, please. I've only got a minute between acts. A tremendous amount of pressure. Okay, we're going to have the steering committee.
All right, Ed.
I could never hold on to my whatever.
Yes.
Okay, we're going to have the steering committee in 1 minute, and what I'd like to have is the red team, who will follow the steering committee, follow Pat Iles. Where's Pat? Hello, Pat? Pat is somewhere. Follow Pat's voice and her hand, which is waving something, a white hanky, go into that exit area and prepare yourself. Also, if you have props to set up, it is permissible to set up the props while I am doing a brief 1 minute shtick on the meaning of life. Okay? Now, before we hear from the steering committee, I have a few announcements to make. Are you ready for this? Okay. Due to the outbreaks of AIDS, it will no longer be necessary to kiss the boss's ass. With the exception of Don Foster, who should continue in his present mode. Wow. One more brief announcement. Donna Ellison Briggs Stratton, Stratione, Parvani Smith, God knows how many names she's going to accumulate, recently asked me, this is quite serious, about rampant bureaucracy in Dataproducts.
Let's get going.
It's a problem. We are addressing seriously Dataproducts at the present time. I'm sitting on a procedural committee which has been set up to review a survey and the feasibility of the study. On just that subject, our subcommittee will coordinate with Gary Bernard's subcommittee on procedures to set up the procedures. I'm presently evaluating the procedures. The business manager committee will review the feasibility, study, and make a decision related to this. I'm sure you understand there are no bureaucracies in Dataproducts. And now, without further ado, I would like to present the fabulous, and the very dear friends of mine, the fabulous steering committee. And I will now announce that the purple team should be going off to see Pat Iles in the corner, a woman who spent a lot of time in corners, and get ready. And while they're setting up, you know, I'd just like to make a few comments, as I usually do. I'm working steady. The ex-wife is happy with her alimony payments. The kids aren't doing drugs. Inflation is under control. You know, I'm running out of reasons to drink. It's quite depressing. You know, I like to tell you when you know it's going to be a bad day out there. You know it's going to be a bad day when you've been at work for 3 hours and you notice your skirt is caught in your pantyhose. You know it's going to be a bad day when you put your bra on backwards and it fits better. You know it's going to be a bad day when you call suicide prevention and they put you on hold. You know it's going to be a bad day when you arrive at work and there's a 60-minute news crew waiting to interview you. You really know it's a bad day when your only son tells you he wishes Anita Bryant would mind her own business. You know it's going to be a bad day when everyone avoids you the morning after the hospitality suite. How many people does that fit? You know it's a bad day, and this is dedicated to Bubba McKee. You know it's a bad day when you take longer to get over sex than to have it. And you know it's a bad day when you notice dandruff on your umbrella. And now Debbie is giving me the finger, something she has done for many years, but I don't know what finger that was. We never did get together what the finger signal was. Do you remember that, David? Debbie, if you could come out and give me the right finger. Are we ready? She's shaking her head yes, which is usually a signal we're ready. And now, without further ado, And by the way, the purple team should be back there, and yellow should be getting ready to follow purple, but you know all that. And now, without further ado, some marvelous and very good friends of mine, the famous Red Team.
Have you ever noticed those cartoons with the swing? As the customer wanted to see it, as engineering designed it, but as product management inspected? Have you ever noticed?
No.
You're a commie dog! Okay. Mike, I'll handle you hecklers later. Okay. What you're going to see this evening is three scenes. What you're going to see this evening is three scenes. Three scenarios, all actually happening simultaneously, but one as viewed by the sales force, maybe a little bit egotistical. One as viewed by engineering, and the third is viewed by product management. Take it away.
Mr. Show.
Yeah? Who are you? What do you want?
Hi, Mr. Schimmel.
I've already told you that. That's twice. Hi, Tom. How are you?
Hi. How are you?
Good. Good.
Well, I'd like to take a few minutes of your time and talk a little bit about our new printer, the 1230. Mind if I sit?
Well, it's customary for me to sit down first. Yeah, I mean, we can do this. Tell me, I mean, how did you? You're with who? Dataproducts? You're not the guy from Genicom that I'm having lunch with today, right?
No.
Oh, okay. All right. I thought maybe he came in earlier or something.
No, I wanted to talk about.
Make it quick, because I'm having lunch and then we're playing golf together, so I don't have a lot of time.
Okay, I'll do that. I'm replacing Cheryl Myers. Cheryl Smith.
Cheryl Smith.
Cheryl.
Yeah, she was that wimpy girl that used to come in. You're replacing her?
Yeah.
Yeah. You work for the same nerdy guy down in Wayne, Randy Schwartz?
Or yeah, that's
Randy.
Shop. Yeah. Yeah. Shop. Yeah. Yeah, right.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Well,
go ahead.
But we thought it was a good business decision.
Am I here?
Hey, there I am.
What I wanted to do was talk to him about our new product, the 1230.
Well, obviously you've heard about it in some of the info worlds and whatnot, and I understand you have a need for non-impact printing at 12 ppm.
Yeah, in fact, that's what I'm talking to the Genicom guy about at lunch. I think we're probably going to go with the Genicom unit. It just kind of fits our needs.
Well, I guess I'd like to get some...
Well, you know, Cheryl tried to talk to me about the 1230 and Randy and some JP guy out in California. I mean, you know, I mean, there's lots of things that are wrong. Let me just tell you know, I mean, my customer base needs PostScript.
Uh-huh.
You know,
uh-huh.
And you guys don't have it. And,
well,
you know,
let me tell you, the 1230 is a wonderful product, and we do have an HP emulation mode. And if you've ever seen PostScript run, you don't really want PostScript.
Not that good? No? I mean, I thought that
have
was
you
like,
seen
I mean,
Seals walk before?
Yeah.
It's about the same speed, you know.
So like IBM's all screwed up, right?
Well, you know, they claim to know what they're doing, but we have an emulation that's I'm sure you're familiar with. It's a Hewlett Packard emulation,
yeah.
And it'll do everything times three what the PostScript does.
Is that right?
And by the way, it's about three times as fast.
And it works.
It's fantastic. I mean, everything you could possibly want to do, your graphics and everything, is an HP. So, you know, relative to what the
HP is a pretty good name. But, well, maybe I don't need PostScript.
I think you'd really be better off with HP. Honestly,
yeah.
I would.
Yeah.
Let's go a little further into the product. What are some of the other things you're looking at?
Fonts. I mean, you know, I sell to all kinds of crazy customers and applications. I mean, I need 40 quadrillion fonts.
We can do that. We can do that. No problem. We have 7 in the printer resident. I guarantee you.
That's a long way from 40 quadrillion.
Well, that's true, but I guarantee you that you won't use more than 3. It's been my experience.
Can we put that in the contract?
Yeah. Yeah, no problem.
Okay.
No problem. It's been my experience. We've had this product out for some time and selling it, you know, for God knows a long time.
Yeah.
And 7 fonts seem to work quite well.
All right. Well, you know, the other thing is my forecast right now indicates that we're going to need about 500 of these, but, you know, I'm going to need quick delivery.
Oh, no problem.
You know, I mean, but I don't want, like, lots of units in inventory either.
No problem. No, but we can deliver. What kind of time frame are you looking for?
Whenever I needed one, I'd just give you an order and deliver in, 24, 48 hours?
Oh, we could do 90 days.
90 days.
Yeah, we could, but there's reasons for this. You know, the program, I mean, you'll sell them. What I'm kind of hoping to do here is be able to get a purchase order out of you, and we'll just inventory the product, and then we don't have to deal with, lead times and delays. If the division gets backed up, so, no problem. You can inventory.
So the idea would be I just give you, one order, and you deliver, a whole bunch in here at once. And
well, that's kind of our intent. That's what we're looking for.
That wouldn't be too bad, because I just negotiated a deal with some guy named Schultz out there in credit.
And he gave me an open line
of credit.
Bob's a great guy. Yeah, Bob, he and I did dinner the other day.
Net 120-day term, so that won't be a problem. Yeah, okay. Well, look, the real problem, though, is price.
Price.
Well, I mean, that thing was...
Let me kind of summarize and recap as to what you're looking for, Art, and I think we can kind of go on from here. HP emulation, I think we've determined, is far exceeds PostScript.
Yeah, sure sounds
what
like
you need,
yeah.
And three times faster and things of that nature. And fonts, we have 7. That's more than what anybody else can do. And as I said, the market only uses about 3.
And you said I only needed 3 anyway.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. So you're all set there. And availability, 90 days is great. I mean, after all, they are coming from Japan.
That way, I only have to write one check. Yeah. That's good.
Yeah, I mean, boats aren't planes. They do take a while to get there. Yeah. So if we can get some in product in your inventory. The retail price, now I want you to understand, this is a good product. And this is one of the best products ever introduced. And I've looked at the numbers we've talked about, and I think we've talked anywhere from, about 1,500 machines, is that right, Art?
Yeah, over a couple of years, probably be something like that.
Well, I'm going to make you what I consider to be a very good offer if, as we talked about the inventory issue, if you'd be willing to take 1,500, now, I'm sorry, I've got to push that to 2,000, if you'd be willing to take 2,000 units, I could give you a price today, if you give me an order, contingent upon that, obviously,
sure,
for $39.99.
$39.99.
Now with that, you get HP emulation, 7 fonts, which we'll only use 3. HP is 3 times as fast, and we only need a unit for 1,500 of them.
Well, that sounds good to me. You've done a job on me. $39.99 a piece.
$39.99, and what I'd like to do is give them to you all at one time. Matter of fact, I can take it in my car.
And then I can mark that up my normal 40%.
Oh, yeah, no problem. No problem.
Hey,
I've got 10 of them in my car.
Hey, listen, I'm going to tell this Genicom guy to hit the roof. You and I will go have some lunch. We'll go play some golf.
Oh, yeah, I appreciate it.
There's
that
all right.
Wonderful.
Good
Thank
job.
You very much.
Yeah.
Of course, that was the scene as the salesman remembered it. Now let's see it as engineering envisioned it happen.
Hey, Tom Pearson, sales.
I'm under the table, head of purchasing cabinet.
Hey, good to see you.
How are you?
We're here to talk about the
1230
today, right? And I've got some
AACs
for you.
Oh,
excellent.
Thank you.
Turn your microphone on, please.
Oh. Me? No, me.
Okay.
Printer works pretty good.
Okay. Why don't we just look over that data sheet and ask me a few questions.
Okay, speed. Could you give me... Well, could you explain a little bit about the speed here, what this 1230 does for me exactly, and all the various modes? I see you offer different applications and emulations here. Could you tell me a little about speed?
Sure. Speed, 12 pages a minute. But, of course, that's with the single bin option. With the triple bin, it's 36 pages a minute.
That makes sense.
If you need high speed and you only got 1 minute, we got a turbo switch. It goes 24.
Turbo switch.
Yeah. Okay. I don't want to overcommit engineering, but they
say. Oh, I'll get to change the oil. Never mind. One of the unique requirements here at ABC Computer Factory is we like to have our units in our colors, pews and orange. Is there any problem with getting molded in color on these products?
Pews and orange. Molded colors, no problem.
Is that a standard color for you, by the way?
Sure.
Okay.
He's not supposed to be a good brain to think like this. But there is a minimum quantity of four for custom cars.
Minimum of four?
That's what manufacturing's.
How about a letter of intent for four? I can give you a solid letter of intent. Solid.
Okay, what other questions might you have?
See here, you have several emulations. Can you sort of go through the list of emulations you have here?
And, No problem. Of course, as I mentioned before, PostScript's going to be available in 2 weeks, fully integrated. No problem.
PostScript. Like
plus
brand flakes?
PostScript. Plus, of course, the standards, Diablo 630, HP LaserJet Plus, and next week we're bringing out DDL, Interpress, and Max Headroom.
That's very impressive. That seems to cover all of our applications. Now, one thing we have, once again, some very unique font requirements. How do you handle the font? What fonts are standard, resident, and how do you get additional fonts in?
Well, we do have font cards. In fact, we just brought out one this week. IGPE FNA font. Also, Farsi and CIA Invisible Ink, new and special.
Font card. Well, how do you implement these font cartridges?
Well, they're like credit cards.
Credit cards. Is there any possibility you could put in an ATM type feature on this? And sort of withdraw cash and get statements and things like that.
Yeah, you can take your ATM card today and it prints out your bank statement.
Providing I have money, of course. I mean, standard.
Of course. What else could we do for you?
How about interface support? What various interfaces do you have that I could use in my system? I'd like to be as flexible as possible. I have several different applications. We try to serve all markets, This is not exactly a vertical thing.
Of course.
Whatever. Well, the old good old whatever it takes,
Sure. Hey, standard Centronics RS-232, RS-422, RS-422-2337. Also, we've got a new kitchen option. Allows you to interface to your toaster.
Good. Microwave, you got that?
Yeah, microwave, no problem. Benzomatic, Mr. Coffee, and even your satellite dish.
Satellite, that's very nice. Okay, so it looks to me like you have like about 750 sheets input. How do you handle the output on this?
Well, you sure you don't want to talk about input?
I want my input's next.
Okay.
Input. I want to talk about input. We've already discussed the 3 minutes. Let's put it in.
Let's talk about input.
Can't get it out to you, put it in.
We accept a wide variety of input papers.
Input or fallout,
Certainly with input, we have one-part continuous forms, six-part cut-sheet forms, crowns, Lederbach, paper towel, no problem. Saran wrap and back issues of USA Today.
You say multi-part forms, so we'll do NCR type paper.
Yes, true.
Okay, great. One thing I notice here is you have a combination pressure and thermal fuser. That's very interesting to me. What are the chances of this baby doing grilled cheese sandwiches?
Grilled cheese we can do, providing it's American. Provolone, no cheese.
Okay, very good. Once you've got all this good stuff in, all this multi-part fan fold, pin feed, wax paper, toilet paper, what do you do with it once it comes out?
Well, we do have a variety of output options, of course. Your traditional face-up and face-down in the mud, plus for our large capacity, we have a 55-gallon trash can, and for a really large output capacity, a 15-cubic-yard dumpster.
Very good. No, I like the dumpster.
Yeah, plus the envelope feeder.
Found the dumpster.
Plus the envelope feeder, which we failed to mention, outputs directly to a Pitney Bowes postage meter.
Ooh.
And then we have the Tempest option, where the Tempest output goes direct to the shredder.
To a shredder? Very secure. I like that. No middleman. You have to read. I'm a reading.
And that about wraps up the features of the 1230.
Well, it looks like a very good product. I think I'd like to. Well, I have to commit to four, huh?
That's right. For the customer guys.
How about an LOI for one?
I'll take it and run. Thanks.
Okay. Thank you very much.
All right.
Okay, of course, that was the same scene as the engineers envisioned it. Now, the next one is near and dear to my heart. This is as product management envisions the same scene.
Hi, I'm Doc.
Foster. I'm from Dataproducts. I'm here to talk to you about our
microphone.
I'm Don Foster. I'm here from Dataproducts. I'm here to talk to you about our laser 1230 printer.
Oh,
how about lunch?
Laser.
Right, right.
Okay, I have a few vendor items here to talk to you about.
Okay.
Like price. I want to know the price. Never mind, I only can pay $3,000.
No problem.
No.
$2,800. Deal. Let's go to lunch.
Sit down. $2,800. Okay. Do you realize that PostScript is very important to us? And I can't pay any more than $4,000. That's all my budget allows.
Easy deal.
Easy deal.
It's included in the original price. Wait. We'll leave an upgrade product you have in the field at your customer site. No extra charge.
No extra charge.
Lunch now?
Deliver it. Now, I don't stock. Everything has to be drop shipped.
No problem. Not only can we drop ship, we can drop ship anywhere in the country in 24 hours.
24
free
hours.
Prepaid.
Free.
Lunch? How about lunch?
Sit down. I got you.
I sure like taking lunch.
Font cards. Now, I can't wait for it to be developed. I need it now. Right now.
We have font cards that you've never dreamed of on the shelf, ready for delivery right now. Wait. We also can develop new fonts that you probably never thought of in a matter of hours and deliver them to your customer sites.
Customer sites. Okay. 20.
Lunch?
I want to go through this. $2,800. No charge.
No
charge for PostScript.
No problem.
Deliver drop ships.
Absolutely.
And font cards in hours.
That's it.
That's it.
How about lunch?